Hey everyone, it's Jamie from Modern Day Fox. Today I'm going to make a red lentil stew in my Instant Pot. You start by setting your pot to saute, and then you're going to add 2 tablespoons of coconut oil and let that heat up in your pot. Next, you're going to dice a small onion and also add that to your hot oil in your pot. You're going to next add 1 tablespoon of minced garlic. And then allow those to saute in the pot for a little while until your onions are translucent for about maybe 3 or 4 minutes. Next, add 2 cans of diced tomatoes. These are the standard 14.5 ounce cans that you get at the grocery store. Or you can get one of those large 28 ounce cans as well. You don't want to drain your tomatoes, just pour it right in your pot. Next, you're going to turn your pot off. And we'll add seasonings, starting with curry powder, and we're going to do 1 tablespoon of curry powder. Next, we'll add 1/2 tablespoon of sea salt, and you may opt to add more salt after it's finished cooking. I did. And then next, we're going to add 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric. Add a dash of black pepper to whatever your seasoning preference is there, maybe like 1/4 teaspoon. And then 1/2 teaspoon of smoked paprika. Next, you're going to add 1 can of light or regular coconut milk. Make sure you use the can kind. And then 2 cups of broth. To keep it vegetarian, make sure you use vegetable broth. I use chicken broth for mine. And then you're going to take red lentils. You want to soak your lentils overnight, so make sure you do that first. And then rinse them and add them to the pot. It's 1 pound of dried red lentils soaked overnight. Stir that well. And then put the lid on your Instant Pot and make sure that you turn the valve to sealing. That is what helps your pot come to pressure. Next, you're going to set your pot to 6 minutes high pressure. It doesn't take lentils long to cook at all, and they can get easily overcooked. Make sure that when the timer goes off, you use a quick release. And you want to make sure to release it right after the timer goes off, because like I said, lentils can overcook very quickly. Take your lid off and then stir your stew well. And just take a taste and see if you need more salt. I like things a little saltier, so I did add more salt. This is ready to serve. It does look a little bit like mush, but it tastes wonderful. It keeps in the refrigerator all week and it's great for meal prep. I hope you enjoyed this recipe. If you did, give it a thumbs up and make sure you visit me at moderndayfox.com.